Okay, in my previous tutorials, I've showed you guys how to make a complete song inside FL Studio Mobile. And we have covered how to make the build-up. How to make the drop. And also the slow part of the song. But there is one annoying problem here. If you play these two parts, realize that the melody and also the bass line just come in suddenly. You almost felt like there's a heart attack in that song. At first is the chords, and then after that, the melody and the bass line comes in. Like, these two bars does not belong together in a song. So, how do we solve this? By adding transitions. Today I'll be explaining like the most popular transitions used in EDM especially. It is called the reverse reverb. I'm going to first show you how to do it, then I'm going to explain why is it called the reverse reverb. The first thing that you want to do is identify the sudden sound, which in this case, is going to be the BD lead here. So what you want to do right now is highlight the BD lead and also solo it so that it only has that sudden sound or the BD lead inside it. And then we're going to export this as an MP3. RR sudden sound. It's okay. And save it. Instead of full song, we're going to select just the selection. High quality, normalized level, and render. Okay, so render complete is under my tracks. So right now, the next step is you're going to add an audio clip. So under my files, my tracks, select the sudden sound that we exported just now. And it is now inside. This time, we're going to solo the imported audio clip only. We're going to reverse this. And then we are going to trim this clip until we only have the beginning sound. Now I'm going to drag this clip here and we're going to highlight at least 4 bars here. I'm going to select the sound and a few bars so that I can test out the reverse reverb here. So right now we have reversed it. Let's add the reverb to it. Select on reverb 2. Now think of reverb as like singing in a very big room. How big is the room is going to be the size, and then how long is the echo sustained is under decay. Now wetness for me, it is how sharp the sound is, but normally I'll increase it to maximum as well. And we play it and hopefully we have a lot of reverb here. Yeah, that is wetness. So you can use the high cut here and the low cut here to cut off any high frequency or low frequency that you don't want. So for example, if I increase this low cut here, there's a lot of low frequency that's been removed, right? But I'm just not going to touch it. I'm just going to leave it because I'm quite happy with that reverse reverb here. Once you're quite happy with your reverse reverb, we're going to save it again as MP3, and then we're going to name this as reverse reverb 2 sudden sound reverb. Again, selection only, leave remainder, normalized level and high quality, and we're going to render. Now we are done with this auto channel, so we can just delete this, and then we're going to bring in our audio clip. So under my tracks again. Okay, so here is our reverse reverb right now. We're going to select it and we're going to press reverse again. And this makes it into a very cool effect where it is reversed. Okay, I'm going to solo it and play it so that you guys can hear how does it sound like. So as you can see, it's a build-up of a sudden sound, and then you have the sudden sound itself. So we're going to trim out that sudden sound. First, remove the snapping by clicking on the magnet button here, and then I'm just going to trim out the sudden sound. OK, Okay, so right now you can put in nicely right before the sudden sound and then turn off solo. If we play it, we can hear how does it sound like. So it is a bit too loud. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop the volume here, fine tune it. So as you can see, it's already bringing in the sound gently. But right after it brings in the sound, something is missing. So what we're going to do here is clone channel, bring the reverse reverb to the back, unreverse it. Again, right before the sudden sound, leave a little bit of gap here, and this one is going to be even softer. Okay, so right now I'm going to let you guys listen to the before. And this is the after. So why is this called the reverse reverb? So you can think of reverb as, let's say I go into a really large orchestra room and I started to sing hello, that echo that comes back, we can call it as a reverb. So by taking a sudden sound, we're gonna have it reverb in reverse. We can slowly bring in the sound using an echo kind of feel. And that is the reverse reverb transition that you can use in your song to bring in any sudden sound so that you can glue two sections of a song together. In this case, it is a chords and also the lead melody of the song, making sure that your listeners don't have like a heart attack from the sudden sound that comes in. Okay, so that is the first type of transition, which is called the reverse reverb. It's widely used in EDM songs. So right now you can even like listen to some of the songs that you really enjoy and you can hear the reverse reverb inside of all of the songs. But there's a couple of types of transitions some more that I want to cover, like the frequency filter. So if you want to see that transition, be sure to subscribe and hit the like button to let me know that you want to see the frequency filter transition. And I'll be sure to do that as fast as possible. Alright, but other than that, if you guys want to learn FL Studio like from start of drop, build up and slow part of the song, be sure to click on this playlist right here and I'll see you in those videos. That's all. Say bye bye.